Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. My name is Ashok, faculty for Reasoning as well as Mechanical Engineering. As a part of our short videos, in this video we are going to discuss a numerical or a reasoning problem. Do subscribe to our channel because you are going to get notifications of these short videos of various modules. You can see reasoning, you can see aptitude, English, general studies, science and engineering concepts. So for those who are preparing relevant examination, so do subscribe because you will be getting the notifications of our short videos. Let us see what we have in this video. So friends, this is another problem related to this inequalities from reasoning ability. So from RBI assistant previous paper of 2012, we have chosen another one. So far we have covered the remaining questions also. So you can watch our short videos. In that playlist you can easily observe. So do subscribe because you will be getting notifications of all such videos. So let us move ahead to understand the next problem in this probably the fourth question. Okay, so this is fourth question from that paper. We have got total five questions in that. Okay, so we all know basic directions, how they are given. We need to check the statement and conclusions. We need to answer appropriate option must be chosen, whether those conclusions are following, how those conclusions are following that statement. So whether they are following or not following, or there must be some case like either or case, so which is very important in this inequalities topic. So we will try to understand whenever you get such cases. Okay, so anyway, one among these options has to be chosen. Let us see. So which option has to be chosen with respect to this given set. So first statement, what we need to check, whether you need to check if it is given in a single statement or a group of statements. Obviously we have got two statements here. First thing we need to do is we need to first identify whether we can merge them or not, or we need to bring them in a single line, or if that doesn't happen, we need to at least rearrange those two statements such that we can make some convenient path to understand these conclusions. Okay, so let us see whether we can make it into single line or we can rearrange those two statements for convenient path. Let me rewrite this statement here. D is greater than E is less than or equal to F. So what is the other statement here? J is less than F. So obviously the common element here is F. So, and common element you could find at the end. It is very much simpler now, that whenever you find a common element at the end, we can easily merge those statements. So from this you can easily understand that J less than F can also be written as F is greater than J. So now that here F is common, so we can replace we can merge this statement into this. While you merge, so what it will become? This will be the single statement we can make from this given group of statements, that is anyway two statements you have. So we can merge them to this single statement. So from this statement we need to infer whether these conclusions can be followed or not. So let us check with this first conclusion if it is following this statement or not. So what is the conclusion given here? D greater than J. So first what we need to do, locate these elements in this statement and try to understand how the relationship has been established there. So whether that relationship established between those two elements, which are these D and J, is matching our conclusion or not, we need to check. So what are the symbols, what all the symbols we have in between? Greater, less than or equal to, obviously here itself we can stop this problem anyway. So let us check anyway. So obvious that we have got one greater, immediately we got another less than or equal to. So obviously the opposite symbols are coming in between, so we cannot establish the relation straight away. Means unless we have some more supporting conclusions, we cannot determine the relation here, isn't it? So appropriate thing is, we cannot word we can say is the relationship cannot be established here, cannot be determined appropriately. So here there is some barrier between these two, means relationship cannot be established here. So obviously this shows that this first conclusion is straight away false, unless which we may see in the other questions, whenever we get the conclusion, supporting conclusions to understand this anyway. So similar questions also we anyway the concepts will be dealt in separate videos also. So for that please subscribe, because you will be getting the notifications about those short videos also, which would clear various concepts in this inequalities topic anyway. So in this question, if you see, first conclusion we made something out of it, that is it is false, it is not following that statement. Next conclusion, if you see, that is E is less than J. Let us check if it is following or not. So first what you need to do, identify the elements here. E is here, J is here. So between these two, identify what are the symbols given. Between E and J, one is less than or equal to, another one is greater. So obviously similar to this. So here less, greater, lesser is given, opposite symbols. Here one lesser, one greater, obviously. So there will not be any relationship can be established here. There will not be any relationship here. I mean, relationship cannot be determined. Okay, unless, as we discussed in the first case, unless some more supporting conclusions are given, we cannot determine that case. Okay, so obviously straight away we can give that it is also false. Means both conclusions are false according to, based on this statement. They are not following this statement. So obviously our appropriate answer for this question is obviously neither conclusion one nor two follows. Neither conclusion first or second follows. So obviously I hope you understood this better way. And the interesting concept here is, you need to understand this. So whenever you have opposite symbols, so we have some analogy with respect to the symbols also, that like poles in the sense, this is pointed, this is pointed. When like poles are facing each other, they repel. Means the relationship cannot be established. With magnetism, that analogy has been made to make it convenient to fix it in your mind. Anyway, so this concept is being explained in our recorded live session. So if you don't find that is not making your concepts clear, just comment in our comment box, so that we'll make a separate video related to that, to clear that concept of whatever the concept related to this inequalities topic. So this is for this video. We have solved fourth question. So let us see, and do watch other videos also, for other short videos also for individual questions. Let us meet in another video. So friends, that was a short video. As a part of our short videos we are doing for your complete preparation, do subscribe to our channel and find other videos also, so that you will be getting the notifications. Please press the bell icon and get the notifications. So I hope you like this video. Do like and share this with your friends, so that it will be helpful for them also. And don't forget to comment, and suggestions if any are very much welcome. Thank you so much for watching this video.